Good morning, new home folks and others out there who may be taking the opportunity to join in with us for a short devotion this morning. Hi to you. I'm Pastor Scott Balcom from New Home Baptist Church here in Peachland, North Carolina. And as you can see, I'm not in the church house this morning. This is the first opportunity I've had to come to you kind of live out in the workplace. This is my second job where I'm here at my farm in one of my sheds, and I just wanted to share with you a quick word of devotion. I hope you're having a great Friday morning, and it's a very beautiful day. The birds have been singing, and I woke up to those birds singing this morning, and that just reiterated to me that God is continuing to be in control, and it's a beautiful day. Lord, the miracles that you post all around us are just wonderful for us to see. So God bless you and welcome to our time together this morning. In my early devotion, one of the ones that I looked at today was from Jeremiah chapter 17, and I wanted to share some scripture verses with you. In this particular passage, Jeremiah is praying for deliverance. He's got some troublesome things upon his mind, and things are not going real good in his life, and he's seeing some issues, so he's crying out to God. So let's see what he says. Beginning in verse 14, he says, "Heal me, O Lord, and I shall be healed. Save me, and I shall be saved, for you are my praise. Behold, they say to me, where is the word of the Lord? Let it come." I'm sure right now many are wondering, where is the Lord of the host? Where is his word shining out in the midst of this tragedy that we're suffering from and all that's going on? But I assure you that he's right where he's always been. He's on the throne, and he loves us deeply, and he wants to reach out to us. As we go on and read in verse 16, it says, "I have not run away from being your shepherd," saying that Jeremiah is continuing to try to be close to God, but he's having trouble finding him. He says, "Nor have I desired the day of sickness. You know what came out of my lips. It was before your face." And then this last verse, verse 17, listen real closely. He said, "Be not a terror to me, for you are my refuge in my day of disaster." Our Heavenly Father continues to be our refuge in our day of disaster. He is still in control, and he is still making provisions for us each and every day. This is sort of my home away from home at times. This is my quiet place where I can draw close to God, and I can allow him to massage my spirit, give me new insights to what he's doing. And I like to stow away here from time to time. And this morning, I feel as close to God as I would if I was in his house today. I know he's there, but he's also given me opportunities to have a sound mind and a sharp mind and make right decisions. So I want to reassure to you that even though Christ is continuing to make ways for us to witness and share his message by media out here each and every day, he still wants us to be very frugal in what we were doing, and he gives us that sound mind to make good decisions. So I want to encourage you today to stay at home if you can, to keep your cross-sectional groups that you come in contact with down as small a number as possible. If you're there with your family, three or four, and maybe you've got some loved ones that you're caring for, try to keep that as small as possible. And when you have to go out, be mindful of who you're around, because each and every time you're around a different group, then when you come back, your circle just got that much broader. And we definitely don't want to bring a problem back to our loved ones, those that we're trying to protect. So be very smart and diligent. I hope you have a great Friday. And hey, I want to encourage you, if you're watching this video on Facebook, like us there on Facebook, share it to anyone that you would like. And if you're looking at it on YouTube, take a few moments to click that you liked it there. That will allow other people to see the video. Also, we'd like for you to subscribe to our new home, that page there on YouTube, New Home Baptist Church. And then once you subscribe, it's free. You can see all the videos that we've uploaded. And also, if you'll hit that little box on the right that shows a little triangle, you can go all the way down to the bottom and make comments. We'd love for you to do that. God bless you. I love you, and I hope you have a great Friday.